Hi, welcome to Promessa. This seemed like an interesting game, and I wanted to play it. And, if I'm already going to be playing it, I might as well record it. So that's what we're doing. The itch.io page says that this game will take multiple playthroughs to see all the scenes. So I'm probably going to stitch on the scenes that we didn't see the first playthrough onto the end of this if I can find all of them. So, Promessa lasts about 45 minutes and has no save system. Headphones and a dark room are recommended. Mouse to look, WASD to move, escape to pause and change settings. During the dialog, press X or enter to continue. Way back, before going to sleep, I used to read, wanting to learn something new every day. Anything, you know? Now I just can't. I don't have the energy anymore. Look, now just reading a single page drains me because I forget right away. That book I lent you? At this point, I've been on the same page for months. Things don't stick with me. They escape me. Oh wow, this is slow camera sensitivity. But okay, here we go. That's an uncomfortable chair to have at your computer. Oh, we're leaving. Okay. That's what I dream about. In the neighborhood, there were no differences. The neighbor's grass was as green as yours, not like today. Life was divine. That's right, that's how life was. And I miss many things. You can't imagine how it was. I still remember. Every time I went back to the neighborhood, I always went to Sam Simpson's bar house. Wow, this is a loud train. Oh, this is interesting. Oh. No? Okay. Truth is, we went back and forth for 20 years. Everything, family, until both of us grew too old. I wanted to go back again, but it was no longer an option. It's like a chasm, something that attracts me, you know? Of course, I've always wanted to go back. I would always go back. It's real drippy in here. How do you think I'm feeling? I'm in a deep hole, laying here, restless, worried, and for that reason, I start screwing around on the computer because I'm sunk, and play rounds of solitaire trying to catch a break. I stay there too long, so I just end up more nervous than I was. Listen, you can neither do anything nor have to. You're living on this far side of the world. It is what it is. What can we do? And it's nobody's fault, really. You see, this is what happens when one spends their entire life traveling. Oh wow, suddenly I have footsteps. I'm no longer a ghost. I am corporeal. That just hit me in the face. Lovely. Where are we going? You see? This morning she was completely lost, out of this world. She was staring at the void. That's what I fear, because I know that one day that emptiness will arrive and she'll be far from everything. Things get a tad more complicated every day. It's hard. Very hard. Anyway, let me tell you, truth is, we were lucky. And here we are, the two of us. It was never an easy life for us, you know? My favorite things in video games is feeling like I'm actually in a place. And this really does that. Feels like I'm somewhere, you know? This place has a lot of floors. See, this is lovely. Such an atmosphere. God. This is what I want in games. This is beautiful. Oh? I saw a dark room and I just thought that's where we were going. Okay. I'll go the other way then. This really just gets the feel of being somewhere, of walking through places. You know? See, I've reached an age where I'm trying to make all that I know not slip away. I used to remember a great deal of things, and now I have to fight every day. I can't learn new things anymore, you know? For me, it's already a lot to keep doing the things I know. Ah, yes, the Hell Store. Real glittery in here. Ah, how people change. You know that I keep forgetting the names of streets? By not wanting to remember all the bad that happened, I forgot a lot of things. Look, the only thing I will always regret is not having learned Russian. One should be born again. What can we do? There are things that I did not learn and that I'll never get to learn. Oh man, this is a banged up door. Maybe the reason this feels so realistic, besides the lighting, right? Is that I don't know if this is different for people who have good eyesight, but I don't really get a good, like, high-definition look at things in my day-to-day life. I have to go up to them to see them well, so I don't know. This is the combination of the lighting and pixelated graphics. It's a lot more realistic to me than a lot of AAA, like, hyper-realism games. There's just something about this that's a lot more recognizable to me. Again, maybe it's because I have bad eyesight. I have bad eyesight and no glasses. But this is... I don't know. There's just something that this itches in my lizard brain that makes me happy. Oh, my shit's gone. Can't have shit in Detroit. It's probably just moving out, is what this is supposed to make you think of. Doesn't mean my first thought wasn't, damn, they stole my everything. Oh, that's it? Okay. Very good. I'm going to at least try to get a few more scenes, I think. I'm going to turn up the walk speed, just because I don't want to spend a whole however long I just spent doing it again for my own sanity. If I weren't, you know, just recording, if I weren't recording, then yeah, I'd probably walk through it atmospheric-like, but... Now, through the scene selection option in the main menu, you'll be able to revisit each scene and visit the ones you haven't seen yet. Oh! Each walkthrough of Promessa is different, and you don't get to see all scenes with only one session. Are you telling me that I can do it easy? Fields are ones you have never seen. No. This is very good for me. Okay. Well, never mind then. This changes things. Yes. Oh yeah, I saw the screenshot of this one. After image of pigeon. Infinite pigeon. Oh? Okay, I'll hang out with the pigeons. Oh! See, this is a place. I don't know how else to describe it. I've played a lot of games, but very few really hit in the area design department like this one does. Oh, here we go. Yoink. It is wild that I'm pretty sure this game was made by 4 people. It's especially wild to me that small games like this can draw more emotion out of me with its design than a lot of bigger games. You know, you would think that having access to a lot of money when you're making a game would make the game better in all aspects, but there's just, sometimes, you know, there's just something that indie games seem to only be privy to. Oh, where are we going? Maybe it's the, you know, a love and care that indie games are usually afforded to have. Because big game companies, you know, they put their employees under crunch. It's like you can love a game, but there's only so good of a job that you can do when you're overworked, you know, when you're stretched thin. Something can be like a baby to you, but if you don't have the energy, you don't have the energy, you know? Oh. Be in the clouds? Oh. Hello. Yes. I like pretending to sit in the chairs. I'm gaining on it. Wait, come back. Is that it? Yeah, that's it. Well, this was a very good game, and I think you should buy it. Again, four people. Four people made this. It's absolutely stunning. Even like, if a whole, like, even if 50 people had made this, I would have still found it. You know, like, there's, it is a marvel that four people could make something like this. It's just, yeah. It's just, you know. But, yeah, that's Promessa. Hope you enjoyed it. You can find a link to the game in the description. And, yeah, see you next time.